Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we bless you this morning, oh God. We came to uplift your name this morning, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God. We came this morning, oh God, to glorify your name, oh God. We are decreeing and declaring freedom in this service, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you that we are free to praise you. We thank you that we are free to worship you, oh God. And we will worship you in spirit and in truth. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. If you are free on this morning, hallelujah, we're going to ask that you would stand to your free feet to lift your hands towards heaven way. Hallelujah, hallelujah. For we came to declare God's glory in this place. For it's all about him. It's not about us, but it's all about him. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Feel free to dance. Feel free to sing. Feel free to clap your hands. Feel free to give God a shout of praise. However the Holy Ghost move in you today, feel free to do just that. Amen.
Thank you, God.
It's a never-ending world, and it never runs dry.
It never runs dry.
It never ending well, and it never. joy that's never ending well, and it never runs dry. It never runs dry. God, I have your peace. It's a never ending well, and it never runs dry. It never runs dry. It never runs dry.
We lift you up, Jesus. We lift you up, Jesus.
Jesus. We lift you up, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Have your way, 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 God. Have your way.
The name of Jesus is made high.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 Jesus, you deserve the glory, you deserve the honor, you deserve the praise, you're worthy of the praise. We give you praise. We give you glory. We Shabbat you on today. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You're worthy, Jesus.
You're worthy, Jesus.
You're worthy, Lord.
So worthy, Lord.
We say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
You made a way.
Thank you, Jesus.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
Yes, God.
You made a way.
You made a way.
You made a way.
Made a way.
You made a way. You made a way. Give me some of that. You made a way.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
You made a way.
You made a way. When my back was against the wall and I felt like it was over, you made a way.
And I'm standing here.
And I'm standing here only because you made a way.
You made a way
He's a healer. He's a healer. He's a healer. He's a healer.
He's a healer.
He's a healer.
He's a healer.
He's a healer.
A way maker.
A way maker.
Mind regulator.
Regulator.
Redeemer.
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 Jesus, Jesus, From God. Amen. Amen.
Faith.
The blessing of Abraham.
It's all on your life.
The
Yeah! Hallelujah. Come on and give God a hand, yes, praise, like you got your inheritance. Yes. Like you know you a seed of Abraham. Yes. Hallelujah. We're going to do it one more time for Jesus. Because yes, some of y'all don't know you a seed of Abraham. I am above and not beneath. I am the head and not the tail. And everything that belongs to me, I'm going to get it.
That's it.
I decree and declare I'm going to
get it.
One more time for the Holy Ghost. I'm going to get it.
I'm going to get it.
Yeah. Woo. We love Jesus in this place. Somebody love Jesus.
Yeah.
You ought to stand to your feet and say you love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Some of y'all looking at me shaking your head, but you better let the devil know you love Jesus. Hallelujah. I have the honor and privilege of introducing our speaker on today, none other than the woman of God herself.
Yeah.
Everybody should be standing on their feet, giving honor to whom honor is due. Amen. The great, the incomparable, often imitated but never duplicated, the warrior herself, Apostle Brenda D. Howard.
Yeah.
Are you ready for the word on today? Hallelujah. She got on her blue today. It stands for royalty and authority.
That's it.
And I believe it's a word in the house on today. So get with it and get all that God has for you on today. Don't leave here the same. Get this word. Put it in your cup. And meditate on it day and night, because it'll change your life. She is a destiny changer. Hallelujah. Look at yourself. She's a destiny changer. I look at myself. She's a destiny changer. Hallelujah. Well, some of us was on a road to hell because of her sacrifice. We on the road to eternal life. You ought to give God a praise. We're going to ask the divine praises to come. Then the very next voice you will hear will be none other than Apostle Dr. Brenda D. Howard. Receive them as they come.
We need the glory. Talking about a visitation, but a move. Live in my worship. Live in my praise. You need the glory. Manifest, Lord, now.
to fall.
Sound
like rain. Holy Spirit. Oh.
Holy Spirit.
We need glory. Send down the glory to kind of glory. The weight of your glory. We need the glory. Send down the glory. Shekinah glory. The weight of the glory. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody give God the glory.
Amen.
Somebody
Amen.
Give God praise
bless
this morning.
God,
come on,
God.
Do it like you're
bless
loving.
You God. Bless you, God. Bless you, God. Bless
do it like
God.
You appreciate him. Do it like he woke you up this morning.
Yes.
You didn't wake yourself up.
Yes.
Do it like you know him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do you really know him? Are you really acquainted with Jesus? Hallelujah. Do you really have a relationship?
Amen.
That's what it's all about, relationship. Hallelujah. If I know when I wake up this morning that he's on my side, if I know that I can talk to him and he can talk back to me, if I know that I have an ear to hear what he's saying to me, it's all about relationship. Hallelujah. If I just got a relationship with my God, hallelujah. We bless God this morning. We thank God for everything that's been done. Amen. We do honor God this morning. Amen. Because he is the head of my life. And I pray that he's the head of your life. And I pray that everything that he's telling you to do, that you will do it with all your might. Amen. That you won't let nothing hinder you from doing the will of God. Amen. We thank God for Pastor Ann this morning. Amen. Thank God for everybody that's here. Most of all, thank God for Mother's Day. Yay! Amen. If it wasn't for the mothers carrying these babies, if it wasn't for the mothers going through the pain, going through the birthing process, hallelujah, where would any of us be? Hallelujah. So we thank God for the mothers today. Come on, give yourselves a hand for the things you have to go through, from the things you have to endure. Hallelujah. Nothing like a mother. Amen. If you still have yours, be grateful. Hallelujah. I don't care what mama was like. When mama's gone, it's a difference. Hallelujah. For those that have lost your mothers on this year or last year, amen, we send our prayers to you. Amen. Hallelujah. It's these kind of days, amen, that, amen, take you back. But we thank God for, amen, God giving us strength. Amen. I bless God for everybody that's here. Amen. And I just honor God this morning. Glory to God. I'm not going to prolong the time this morning. Amen. Because, amen, I just want God to be magnified. And whatever he does, let God be seen. Hallelujah. So I get out of his way and say, Lord, have your way. Not my will, but let thine be done. Amen. And when my will get in your way, then move me out of the way. Hallelujah. I've long told God, Lord, I don't want to get in your way. God, if I get to the point of not pleasing, you take me out of here. Y'all don't understand that. Before I mess up, take me out of here. Because I got to see you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sometimes we can go through this journey. Amen. And then we get weary and we want to mess up at the last minute. Before I mess up, take me out of here. We bless God. Hallelujah. I want to see Jesus. Hallelujah. I want him to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Now enter into my presence. I want to hear that from him. See, y'all not excited about it. I get excited. But see, we didn't come here to stay. Some of y'all preparing to stay. I did not come here to stay. This is just the old people, you said, dressing up room. You getting rid of the old things. You getting rid of those hindrances. You getting rid of all that, all those things that will not dwell in the kingdom. Hallelujah. And we here so that God can be glorified. Amen. I thank God for everything that he's done, everything that he's yet going to do. If God be for us, he's more than the whole world against us. Amen. If it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I do? Where would I be? I was telling them this morning in leadership, I could have been one of those under the bridge somewhere. But by the grace and the mercies of God, I could have been one of those that did not have a place to stay. But by the grace of God, he's been merciful. Hallelujah. And because He's been merciful unto me. D, it's all right. God's putting you in a place. He's putting you in a place. Hallelujah. You're going to see the blessings. The Bible said, don't get weary in well doing, for you're going to reap if you faint not. Oh, I'm blessed today. Amen. Well, I'm going to try to get into the Word of God. Amen. And we're going to move on today. Amen. God has been dealing with me. Go to Galatians chapter 5 for me. Amen. Verse 22. Very familiar portion of scripture that talks about the fruit of the Spirit. And the way that you judge yourself is how much fruit do you see on your tree? What kind of fruit is on your tree? Saints now, they're not judging themselves by their fruit. They're judging themselves by what they can see and the works of the flesh. But the Bible says, read verse 22 for me. NIV. Galatians 5:22. We thank God for Apostle Jenkins, amen, and all the people of God, amen, amen, Deacon Dumas, amen, just everybody here today, amen. Galatians 5:22.
It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is...
But the fruit, there must be fruit coming on your tree, and this fruit is coming through the Holy Spirit. You don't have fruit just because you saved. You have fruit because you have submitted to God, and these things begin to come alive in your life. If you don't see love there, it's something wrong with your tree. It's time to examine your tree. It's time to figure out what's growing on your tree. Read.
But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy.
Now, come on. Love. We always say we got love, but how are you showing that love? I can have love all I want, but if I'm not showing that love and moving that love forth, then it's a sounding brass and a tinkling cymbal. It's just a thing that I say out of my mouth that I got, but I'm not showing you anything. See, when Jesus went by the fig tree was pretty. It had leaves, but there was no fruit. Many of you got leaves with no fruit. Where is your love? How are you judging people instead of loving them? Love covers a multitude of sin. How can I say I love you and see you destitute and naked and don't try to do anything about it? How can I say I love you, but you're the topic of my conversation? How can I say I love you? What's my fruit producing? Back up a little bit. Let's look at the works of the flesh. See, what my fruit is. You're going to know me by my fruit. We say we Christians, but what are we producing? What's on your tree? Uh-huh. Say we Christians, but what are people seeing in our lives? Let's pray, because I feel a interference here. Because I want you to get this today. God has been dealing with me about this. Because I'm going to get to a place and I'm going to show you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, as we come before you this morning, God, we lay everything down that's not like you. Father, we put ourselves on the altar this morning and we ask you to have your way. Father, it's not our will, but thine will be done. Father God, we move every interference. We move every boundary. Lord, we tear down every wall, God. Father God, we ask the Holy Spirit to come in this place. We
We ask the Holy Spirit to dwell here. We ask for the angels of the Lord to dwell in this place, that your word will fall upon good ground. Father, we thank you that preaching will be easy today, that the hearts of the people will be open to receive. Father God, that there will be no resistance. Father, we thank you right now for the blood of Jesus that covers this place, the blood of Jesus that covers our lives, the blood of Jesus Christ, that was shed on Calvary. Lord, we thank you for the blood. Father, we thank you right now, and we submit ourselves into your hands. Do what you want to do. Say what you want to say. And when you finish, we finish, God. Have your way, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Go look at me. Go with me tonight. Galatians 5:19, whole 20:22.
The acts of the flesh.
The acts. Now remember, the fruit of the spirit, but the acts of the flesh. What the flesh does. Flesh. The more you satisfy flesh, the more flesh wants to be satisfied. But if you're going to serve God, there must be fruit on your tree. There must be something that you're producing through the Holy Spirit. There must be something people can see, and it's got to be real. It's got to be authentic. It's got to be coming from the depths of your heart. If we can do things out of form or fashion, but when it comes from the depth of your heart, people know that you are for real. Jesus said we should know the truth, and the truth shall make us free. The acts of the flesh. Read.
The acts of the flesh are obvious. Sexual immorality.
Sexual immorality. When you have got rid of the works of the flesh, means that you're keeping under your body. You're keeping your body pure. Why? Because of Jesus Christ. Because you fear God. Because you don't want anything coming between your relationship with you and God. It's time to stop playing church. Amen. Sexual immorality. Doing things that's ungodly. And saying, I'm a Christian. Read.
Impurity and debauchery. Idolatry and witchcraft.
All those works of the flesh. Come on.
Hatred, discord, and jealousy. All right. Fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissensions, actions, and envy.
Does that sound like God?
No, absolutely not.
Come on.
Drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God.
So when you live like this, performing the acts of the flesh, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. Now, the devil's been lying to you, telling you that God understands that God's going to let you in. God is not going to let you in when you are working out of your flesh. We got to bring this body subject to the power of the Almighty God. What is on your tree? What kind of fruit are you bearing? Are you the one that's immoral, sexually immoral, impure? Anything come out of your mouth, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. What's in your heart is going to come out of your mouth. So when you say, oh, I cursed, but I didn't mean to do it, you lying. You meant it because it's in your heart. You never got rid of it. When you are saved, you become a new creation. All things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. So when all things have become new, now I make it my business to work on possessing the fruit to become on my tree. Can I do it by myself? No. It's through the grace of the Holy Spirit that I allow myself to come subject. Which is what I want to minister on today. I want to go get to self-discipline. Because in the church, in this season, it's self-indulgence, not self-diligent. is self-indulgent instead of self-discipline. I bring my body subject. I tell flesh, you're going to do what I tell you to do, not I do what you tell me. You're going to tell flesh, you got to decrease that God can increase in me. Read verse 22.
But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy.
Now, hold right there. How many saints have some joy?
Amen.
If you don't have no joy, that means that something on your tree is not right. The Holy Spirit's not moving like it ought to if you don't have no joy. Uh-oh. See, you think, well, you know, I've been through this and I've been through that and I've been to those. But so be it. We all been through something. Jesus went through something. He suffered the same thing that you suffer. He suffered the same thing that I suffer. But the Bible said he was without sin. How can you serve God and don't have no joy? Who wants to come and be a part of you if they can't see some joy? The world has all of that, the foolishness, but the church. When I come into church, what do I see in the church? What fruit am I seeing not coming out of the church? If I come into church and people sitting around and they ain't got no joy, they can't even throw their hands up and say, thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. They can't even be grateful to God for God bringing them thus far because I made it on my own. The devil is a lie. That's a deceptive spirit. You never made it on your own. You couldn't even get out of the bed if God didn't allow you. It's time for us to get some fruit on the tree. Read.
Love, joy, peace, forbearance.
Oh, stop.
I'm sorry.
Peace. Some of you have no peace. The shalom of God. Shalom means wholeness, health, monies. You have no peace. You're walking around every day, but your mind is in turmoil. Many of you all are going through mental crises. You're going through mental and emotional incidences, and there is no peace. So when you lay down, you really don't rest, and so it causes things to happen in your body that shouldn't be happening because you're not resting because there is no peace. Can you see how the enemy don't want the fruit to show in your life? He wants you to be full of torment because you won't yield to God. You're yielding to the world. You're not yielding to what God says you can have. You're yielding to what you want to do. You're yielding to what I think, what I feel. You feel a lot of things. Many times you got to press past your feelings. Many times I don't feel like getting up out of the bed, but I got to push myself up. If I worked on feelings, I wouldn't be working. But we want to, how do we feel? It's time to get out of your feelings and allow God to work peace in your life. Read, what's the next one?
Forbearance.
When I can forbear things, long suffering.
Yes, God.
Some of y'all don't want to suffer. You want everything laid out for you. Especially this generation, what's called Generation Z? You want everything laid out for you so that all you can do is go pick it up and think, and I got this. I got to never giving God the glory. Long suffering. You got to be willing to suffer long. You got to be willing to suffer without complaining. You got to be willing to suffer without all the time somebody got to pet you and pamper you and give you and self-pity. You got to be willing to suffer and say, God, I'm willing to suffer for the kingdom's sake. I'm willing to suffer just so I can dwell with you. You suffered in the flesh. You told me to arm myself likewise. Now I'm willing to suffer. I'm willing to go through. I'm going to get my flesh out of the way. I'm going to let you crucified. I'm going to let you bring a subject because I got to do something different. I got to show my family something different.
different. I got to show the church something different. When people come in, they got to see somebody that's strong, somebody that's got, that's long-suffering, that don't mind suffering, don't mind going through, not so much interested in what is the outcome other than I got eternal life. I'm not working to stay here. I'm not preparing to stay here. So what I got to do, I got to prepare for eternity. Forbearance, long suffering. Well, I thought it should have been over yesterday. No, You didn't learn the lesson. You didn't pass the test. You got the complaining. You sat down on the job. You backed up. Hallelujah. When you can learn to suffer long, and I'm not even where I need to be yet. Kindness. How can you be, say you're a Christian and not be kind? You got to be kind to one another. If I fight and devour, we fight and devour one another, we're going to destroy one another. But if we show kindness to one another, then we all going to go the same way. We all going to come up at the same, going to come up. But because kindness, I can at least tell you how you're doing this morning. God bless you. But when you get so selfish that you can't be kind to one another, because I got an issue. So I got one too. Let me tell you mine and see who trump who's. I got one too. Whoever sitting here got one too. See, we get so caught up in our issues that we forget to let God bring forth the fruit. We forget to let God do what he wants to do in us because we're so used to. A man is so used to doing it their own way. And the world has come into the church, whereas the church feel like, I can do it my way. I can do it the way I want to do it. I can do it the Burger King way, and it will not be. Stop fooling yourself. Stop letting the devil give you that lie. You got to do it God's way. And I promise you, you will excel anything that you could ever think when you do it God's way. Come on, goodness.
Goodness. Faithfulness.
Let's stop at goodness. I want to take this step by step today, but I'm getting to the last one. That's where I want to stop at. Uh-huh. Goodness. God's, anything God made, he made it good and very good. God made me. He made me good and very good. He said when I would do good, evil is always present. So I got to make a decision to do good and not evil. This gets me into knowing the word of God. What pleases God? What dissatisfies God? What makes God sad? How can I please God? Is the fear of God in my heart? And I'm not talking about that scary fear. I'm talking about a reverential fear. God, because you are God, I fear you. Because you are God, I take notice of you, God. I don't want you to be sad. I don't want you to be angry because you are my God. So I want to do everything that I can to please you. And Lord, if I fall, you made a way of escape because you said if I repent, you are faithful and just to forgive me. Though a just man falls seven times, the Spirit of the Lord will reach down, oh God, and pick him right back up again. How many of you been picked up by God? How many of you made a mistake and God was right there to help you back up? How many of you thought that you could not rise above that, but God stepped in? God showed you that you were worth it. Hallelujah. You were worth every drop of blood that he shed. You were worth every time that he was hit. You were worth every time that they spit on him. You were worth it. Hallelujah. But we don't see goodness. And if God made me in his likeness and made me good, why can't I show you goodness? Why can't I show you kindness? Why I gotta judge you? Because the Bible said, judge not that you be not judged. Because if the same judgment you judge somebody else, you're going to be judged with it. You're going to reap what you sow. If you sow it, you're going to reap it. And when it comes back, it's going to come back worse. These things ought to be manifest in our lives. That means we should be able to come in the church and we got so much joy that can't nobody even contain it, because it's coming from the Spirit. It's coming from the Holy Spirit that lives in us. So I got so much joy. I got my own praise service going on over here. I got my own worship service going on. I don't care if the music ain't right. I don't care if the praise team ain't praising right. I don't care what I got in my head, in my spirit. I got a melody going on that don't nobody know about it but me and God. See, when you get the joy on the inside of you, where you get the peace on the inside of you, and you know didn't nobody do it but God. You know when you was in turmoil, when you was in torment, and you couldn't even sleep at night, when God stepped in, and he changed that situation, and he changed that circumstance, and you got out of that one, and you got right into another situation, but God was faithful. Hallelujah. Glory. When you think about the goodness of Jesus, how he brought you out, how he brought me out. Hallelujah. Many times, people have given up on us. They said we wasn't going to make it. They said we wasn't going to be here today. They said we wasn't going to amount to anything. But God says, not so. You are my special treasure. You are the one that I kept hid behind the mountain. You are the one that I allowed to be trampled upon. You are the one that I allowed to be talked about. You are the one that I brought through the fire. You are the one that I put my glory on. Hallelujah. So that I could get the glory out of your life. So that when nobody else have a praise, you standing in the corner praising me all by yourself. When nobody else had a praise, when nobody was falling on their face crying out to me, you were crying out all by yourself. Glory be to God. And I heard you, and I came in, and I began to dwell with you. For the Bible says, if any man, Jesus standing at the door and knocking, if any man will open up the door, he will come in and he will sup with him. He would have dinner with you if you just invite him in. He would sit at your table if you would just invite him in. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We're going to keep on. We're down to faithfulness now. How many are faithful in God? When things are not going right, you can still hold your course. When it seems like everything falling out around you, can you still hold your course? Can you still trust God? When you still understand, God is not setting me up to fail, but he's setting me up to prosper. When it seems like things are, oh hallelujah, things are looking bad, like money is funny, children acting crazy, go to church and don't feel like you want to go, but you press your way anyhow, and God meets you there, because you were faithful, hallelujah, because you didn't give up, hallelujah, didn't feel like it, body was hurting, glory to God, pain everywhere. But you still press your way. You still got up because you knew that God is able. If you could just get me to the house of God, if you could just get me where the Spirit of God dwells, if I could just
just get there. Something's going to change. Something's going to happen. Oh, glory. Faithfulness. When I didn't want to do my job, faithfulness said you got to do it. Because the Bible says, if you're faithful over a few things, I'm going to make you rule over many. So in order for me to get rule over many, I got to sweep the flow. But I got to do it faithfully. Because many times that's where I get my anointing, from sweeping the floor. Sometimes God will look at how good you sweep that floor. And it says, now is the time for me to elevate them. Because they done a real good job. And when people were walking around throwing paper down, just because they could, they didn't complain. They just reached down and picked it up. They were faithful unto me. And I'm going to be faithful unto them. Oh, glory to God. They didn't give up. They didn't stop. Hallelujah. But they kept on moving. They kept on doing. They kept on blessing me. Now it's my time to bless them. I believe in the book of Acts. Acts chapter 10. I love that story about Cornelius. Cornelius, it was not even time for God to bless the Jews. But Cornelius was from the Italian band. He was one of those that stayed on his face. He cried out to God. He gave to the poor. He gave unto God. And one day God looked upon Cornelius and he said, I gotta bless him. The Bible said that what he had done came up as a memorial before God. Glory be to God. God said, I gotta bless him. Not only am I gonna bless him, I'm gonna bless his whole household. Hallelujah. So he had Peter. He made him hungry, but the food wasn't ready. He went on the top of the house. Oh, hallelujah. When he got up there, he kind of dozed off. And the Lord gave him a vision three times. When he gave him a vision three times, he saw a sheet. Glory to God. And all kind of unclean animals. He said, God, you know, I never eaten of any unclean animal. But God said, that's all right. What I say is clean, is clean. Glory be to God. See, sometimes we judge. Hallelujah. But God said, they belong to me. Glory be to God. So he was preparing him to go to Cornelius' house. Hallelujah. And leave a blessing, not only for Cornelius, but for his whole household. Because Cornelius was faithful unto a God that he had only heard about. A God he had not experienced the way the Jews had experienced him. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Faithful. Glory to God. If I can just be faithful, not just going to church, if I can be faithful in working, if I can be faithful, if I got to get on the parking lot and pick up trash, it's all right. Because I know I'm working for the kingdom. And if I pick up trash long enough, maybe God will look at me and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You picked up that trash real well. Now I'm going to elevate you. See, sometimes people think you elevated because of who you are and how good you are. Sometimes it deals with your faithfulness over that God has put in your hands, over the little things that man count little, those things that don't know anybody else want to do. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 23, come on. Gentleness. Hallelujah. Sometimes we are so harsh with one another. We are just harsh. It's time. Gentleness. Be gentle. Just like you would with a baby. You don't just handle a baby any kind of way. You're protective of that baby. You're protective of that baby's head. You tell him when they're going to hold a baby. Look, protect his neck. Don't let his neck go now because he's not strong enough in his neck yet to hold it up by himself. Don't put your hand in the crown of his head because it's still soft. Hold him because he might jump out of your arms. So you're very tender with that baby. What about the people of God? Sometimes harshness.
We think harshness is getting the job done, but it's not. It's not a fruit of the Spirit. Gentleness. Treating one another with kid gloves. Yeah, I'm going to rebuke you when it's time to rebuke you. But let me show you God. God will come in here. You will have a service, and God will rebuke you real good. Before that service is over, God going to bless you. Why? Because he's just that kind of God. Why can't we treat one another that way? Now, I'm getting to the one I really want to talk about, which is self-control. Many times, or temperance, the King James says it's temperance. Now, another word for self-discipline and self-control is temperance. It's glory to God. It's self-discipline, self-rule, self-mastery. And the opposite of self-discipline or self-control is self-indulgence. Now, if you look at self-indulgence, all the works of the flesh will come under self-indulgence. Because I'm indulging, I'm giving flesh what flesh wants. I'm giving flesh everything it wants. And one thing about flesh, the more you give it, the more it requires. You walk away and get very, very slack in God. And you see, you can't constantly drawing back. Because the flesh lusts to stay away from God. But the Spirit longs after God. So when my flesh wants to act up, the Spirit of God in me says, you got to back down. You got to get it together. Now let me give you a definition. A self-disciplined person, self-discipline means to exercise power over oneself. Many of you do not have power over yourself. You're doing what your flesh is telling you to do. My flesh tells me I shouldn't go to church today, so I'm not going. Okay, boom. My flesh tell me I need to say something to that person because they hurt my feeling. No self-control. There are some times when you need to sit down and ask God, how do I approach the situation? Because I don't want to make it worse. I want to make it better. I don't want to make an enemy. I want to make a friend. Self-control. Many times people in the church, they don't have self-control. They just speak anything. Just like Peter until Jesus died, and when you read the scripture, Peter had no self-control. Whatever came up, came out. And it got to a point where Jesus rebuked Peter because he couldn't control his mouth. Many of you can't control your mouth. Your mouth controls you. Self-control. Isn't it amazing how the enemy is destroying through lack of self-control? Making people feel like, well, if I'm in the church, you know, I just don't have no freedom. What you need freedom for? Serve God. He's going to give you all the freedom you need. The world got a lot to offer you, but it's not good for you. The world's got a lot to offer, but it's destruction. God has set a system in place to bless you and to keep you focused. But what do? You fight it. Because ain't nobody going to control me. I'm going to do what I want. Keep doing it. It's one thing about God. He'll keep dealing with you and dealing with you until after a while, he'll just back up. Now, you're on your own because you wouldn't hear. Self-discipline. The ability to keep oneself under control. Many people don't keep their bodies in line with the Word of God. So the fruit that's coming on the tree is not self-control. It's the acts of the flesh. When I made a decision to serve God, I gave my life to him. I'm living in a different lifestyle than what I would have been living in the world. There has to be a difference. When you accept Jesus Christ, you say, I accept the conditions of serving him. What are the conditions? They're in the 66 books. But what I got to read it. I got to study it. I got to find out what God's saying about me, what I need to do. Self-discipline. Well, you know, I just can't forgive. I just can't let go. But what does the word say? If you can't forgive others, God won't forgive you. Who are we? Well, I can get angry. I'm just flesh. The Bible said, be angry, but sin not. Don't let the sun go down upon your anger. But many of y'all carry anger for weeks and months and years. And you don't understand that you're in jeopardy because you have no self-control. Whatever I want to do, I'm going to do it. They don't know about it. I'm going to do it. And then when I come into church, I'm going to be just as sanctified as everybody else. Yeah, you got leaves on the tree and no fruit. Jesus cursed that tree. Self-control. Many of you just so out of control, you don't have enough control to say, I'm going to pray three times a day. Or I'm going to pray in the morning before I get up, before I leave home. And when I come home, before I go to bed, I'm going to pray. I prayed yesterday. If that's all you prayed was yesterday and you got, and it's keeping you, you better than me. The Bible told me to pray without ceasing. When I'm walking down the street, I'm praying. When I'm driving in my car, I'm praying. I've always got a prayer in my heart. I'm always talking to God. I'm always communicating with God. And then when you're talking to God, you got to get honest. See, the thing is, most of y'all don't want to get honest. Well, God, this is not me. You know, they came at me, God. I didn't have nothing to do with it, God. And God said, you a lie. You got to bring that thing subject. You got to get honest. God, I got this problem with anger, and I need you to help me. God, I'm in a situation here, and this anger is about to destroy me. I need you to help me. See, you got to get clear with God what's going on with you. He already knows, but you got to confess it. You got to let God know. Lord, I can't bring my flesh under control, but through the Holy Spirit, you can help me. God, I got this problem, and this problem is about to destroy me. Help me to bring it subject. Help me to control my flesh. Help me to bring flesh subject. Flesh is destroying me. Flesh is ruling my life right now. And if flesh is ruling my life, God, that's not you. The works of the flesh, the acts of the flesh. What is my flesh producing? What does my flesh cry out for? You ever been on a fast? And you trying to come off all this food and you see these chicken legs running across your eyes? And you say, oh God, some chicken would be real good right now. But you tell your flesh, look, you coming on a suggestion. You're not eating nothing right now. See, that's how you fast. Because flesh gonna always want some. That's what fasting helps you to bring this flesh subject. That's why when y'all say y'all fasting and I don't see flesh coming subject, they ain't fasting right. Because I know what fasting, true fasting, I know what it does. It brings your flesh. So you be so humble. Somebody can step on your feet and they say, I meant to do it. You say, oh, I'm sorry. Did I do something to offend you? blessing or cause the fruit to manifest in your life. But if you don't have self under control, your flesh is gonna work, and it's gonna overtake. Peter said, no, he didn't say that. John said, see how the devil? John said, I must decrease that he can increase. That means I got to bring this flesh subject. That means I got to keep under this flesh. The minute flesh gets out of control, yes, it's hard to bring it subject. You ever got to a place where you stopped praying like you used to? And you tried to get back there, and that was one of the roughest things for you to discipline yourself and bring yourself back under. Because flesh is not standing up. Flesh said, you've been giving me this, and I want it, and I want more. Wow. But you got to be determined, yeah, to say, mm-mm, flesh, you're not going to have this. I'm in control. The Holy Spirit is in control. You got to bring it subject. Is it going to hurt? Yes. Because that means that's going to be something that you want, you're not going to be able to eat. See, we talk about losing weight, and I'm one of the first. Jesus help me. And we don't want to discipline ourselves. There are some things you know that if you eat, it's going to hurt you. But because of self-discipline, you have none. So you eat it anyhow. Then you want to complain to God. God, I need you to heal me. Why should he heal you? You knew you wasn't supposed to eat all that salt. People saying, I got him. I don't know. You knew that you was not supposed to eat all that food, but you ate it anyhow. You knew you weren't supposed to eat all those sweets, but you want to lose weight. I'm losing weight. No, you're not. How you going to lose it? It's time to face reality. In order for me to lose weight, I got to exercise, and I got to stop eating. I got to stop eating certain foods. I got to eat a lot of vegetables. I got to eat proportions. Portions, not these big old plates, not going back the second time. See, we talk about self-discipline. You have no self-discipline. The word indicates self-mastery over one's inner desires. You desire, your flesh desire things, but your spirit says, oh no, I can't oblige you. You think flesh, especially some of y'all unmarried folk, flesh rises up, but you got to tell flesh, oh no, not today. Find you something to do. Get in the word, get in prayer, fast. Do something to bring it subject. When we allow our minds to take control, it'll take you anywhere. So you got to get things out of your mind. Well, God, you know, I just could not contain myself. Get me 1 Chronicles 7:9. I just could not contain myself. Isn't it amazing how people can lay down with somebody and don't want to marry them? Gee, one thing about it, I ain't scared of the devil. I'm going to tell you what's the truth. Now, I might have to suffer the consequences after, but I'm going to tell you the truth. Read that for me.
1 Chronicles 7:9. Mm-hmm. Their genealogical record listed the heads of families and 20,200 fighting men.
1 Corinthians, I'm sorry. Uh-huh. 1 Corinthians 7:9. We gotta bring ourselves under. If you're going to make it with God, because remember now the works of the flesh or the acts of the flesh, he said they won't make it to the kingdom. And his word would not come back to him void. Read.
But if they cannot control themselves.
If they cannot control themselves.
They shouldn't. Marry.
They should marry.
For it's better to marry.
For it's better to marry
than to burn
than
with
to
passion.
Burn with passion. It's amazing how people can lay down with somebody and not be committed to that. Want somebody to be committed to them. If you're gonna get the milk free, why buy the cow? I mean to shut the devil down today. Because self got to come subject. Elders, Titus 1:8, give me Titus 1:8. Elders, you have to bring yourself subject. You got to control yourself. Body of Christ, you have to control yourself. Leaders, you have to control yourself. When you cannot control yourself, you are fooling yourself thinking you're going to grow in God. What I wrote here, a self-disciplined person is more likely to take control of his or her life. Some of y'all don't have control of your life. You going from just how things happen. You don't set goals. You don't have a vision. You have nothing. Just however it falls, that's what you do. No plans. I hit them then. That rock hit hard. Have no control over your life. A self-disciplined person is most likely to take control of his or her life. Set goals. What goals do you have? Are you just existing? God meant for you to do more than just exist. Take steps of faith to accomplish them. You just don't do a vision board and it just sits there. And God gonna make it happen. No, he's not. What are you going to do to get this thing moving? What are you going to do to take that first leap of faith and let God come in and help you? You can do a vision board all you want. But the Bible said, write the vision and make it plain. That they may run. Run mean action. If you don't put something behind it, all you got is some pictures and some writing on a board. But when you put some faith with what you're doing, with that vision, it will come to pass. A self-disciplined person is more likely to take control of his or her life. That's why many of y'all cannot be stable because you have not exhibited self-control. Your life is out of control. Just whatever happens, happens. I'll flow with whatever happens. Uh-uh. I'm not going to flow with just whatever happens. Whatever happens, I'm going already. Got an A, B, and C to help myself. Set goals and take steps. Don't just sit down on the promise, but move toward the promise. When they were walking through the wilderness, they wasn't sitting down. They were walking. Even though they went around that tree 40 years, at least they were moving. Some of y'all just sit down. You didn't even walk around the tree. You got to move it forward. Yeah, it might take a little longer than you thought it should have taken, but at least you're moving. You got a plan. You see some things happening along the way because you're putting your faith out there. You're bringing yourself under control. On our vision boards, we want financial growth. I bet you on every vision board that's in here that's got a vision board. You got, I want financial stability. I want to get out of debt. Well, what are you doing? How many bills are you trying to pay off? Are you still just spending just for the sake of spending? Because I got the money, I'm going to spend it. That's reckless. That's having no self-control. Well, I can stop by Burger King Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So you're going to give Burger King your money, and you got bills that you laying up at night crying over. It's time for us to bring self. When I bring myself under control, then everything else is going to line up, because I'm going to begin to bring my finances under control. I'm going to bring my spiritual life under control. I'm going to bring my natural family life under control. I'm going to bring my study life under control. I'm going to bring everything under control, because I'm now bringing myself subject, because of the fruit of the Spirit, which is helping me to bring it subject. Read for me.
Rather, he must be hospitable.
Go read above this.
Go above that. Since an overseer manages God's household, he must be blameless, not overbearing, not quick-tempered, not given to drunkenness, not violent, not pursuing dishonest gain. Rather, he must be hospitable, one who loves what is good, who is self-controlled.
Self-control. That's what I'm trying to get to. Y'all can go back and read all that other stuff. It's good. But I'm talking about self-control.
My God.
When you start bringing self under control, you will see everything else begin to line up. But when you are out of control, nothing lines up. It is just a free-for-all in your life. But yet, I'm serving God, but you yet complaining. Well, God, I don't see nothing happening. Well, why don't you see things happening? God said he's doing it. He said he's opening doors for you. He said to just ask me. But some of y'all don't even want to ask. Well, Pastor Ann, asking, that's enough. I get it. No, you won't. Ask, and it shall be given. Because you don't bring self under control, flesh takes over. Self-discipline. Temperance. Can't get mad every time something happens. Can't get out of control every time something happens. Gotta control your emotions. Gotta control yourself. Everything my flesh wants, I can't give it. In fact, I got to tell flesh, I maybe can give it to you, but I'm not. Why am I not giving it to you? Because if I keep giving you what you want, you're going to want more. So I'm gonna be in control. Me through the Holy Spirit is going to be in control. I'm going to give you the 12 spiritual disciplines, and I'm going to be finished. No, I got one more scripture. 1 Corinthians 9:22. That'll be last scripture. 1 Corinthians 9:22. The 12 spiritual disciplines, Bible study. Write them down. When you start studying the word, prayer, have specific times that you pray. When you say, if you said, I'm going to meet God at 3 o'clock in the morning, or I'm going to pray at 3, God will meet you at that time, or 5 o'clock, or whatever time you pray. Bible study, number 2 was prayer. Meditation, meditate on the word. Think on the word. Don't just read and forget about it. Think on it. If you got to get one scripture and think on that scripture, then worship. Now, I don't have in the right order, but understand what I'm saying. Worship. Spend time in worship before God. Spend time fellowshipping with God. Number 6, make confession. When you start confessing your faults and being honest with God. See, God knows you anyway. Then give him your service. Whatever you can do for him, give it to him. Don't hold back. Don't say, well, they doing everything. I don't need to do nothing. Yes, you do. Hallelujah. Get generous with God. If you don't have the money, give him your time. I might not have any finances right now, but I'm gonna come to prayer. When y'all having prayer, I'm gonna be out there every time the door. Y'all say prayer. When y'all cleaning the church, every time you get ready to clean the church, I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna be generous with my time. Rest. There are some times you have to take rest. When you are moving and doing, you don't want to get burned out. There are some times you have to take time to rest. And I said, well, rest. God rests on the seventh day. And he said, they're going to become a day of rest for the saints. So this body, you have to, in order to keep the body functioning, there are some times you have to rest. That means you got to cut the TV off. You got to put the phone aside. You got to put the computers aside and rest. Just tell everybody you got to talk to, look, if it's an emergency, you call this person. Because now I just got to rest this body. I know what it is to burn out. When you have no more to offer, because you just burned out. That's not a good feeling. So take time to rest. Now don't rest all the time. Now don't. Not all the time. Use some wisdom. Then there's a time to celebrate. Celebrate what God has done for you. Celebrate what God is doing in your life. Celebrate what God is doing for your ministry. Celebrate what God is doing for your family. Hallelujah. Sometimes we just take it for granted. Jesus had celebrations. Then number 11, be chaste. Hold yourself for Christ. Don't love yourself enough to say, I'm not going to give myself in every situation. And see, this is another area. All this porn y'all looking at. It'll take you in a place that you don't want to go. It'll put a drive in you that you don't want. Stay away from it. Bring yourself under control. See, that spirit will not let you bring it under control because it puts a drive and you want it. You want more and more and more. And then disciple making. Go and make other disciples. Talk to somebody about Jesus. Tell them about how free you are, how loving and kind you are. Tell them about the fruits of the spirit. Tell them when I brought myself subject. That God began to do something for me. Hallelujah. When we think about everything that God has done, and we bring ourselves, allow the Holy Spirit to bring ourselves, help us to bring ourselves subject, discipline ourselves, know when to speak and when not to speak. Because sometimes people just speak out of turn. Know when to hold your mouth. When you're in an arguing situation, you got to know somebody got to be quiet. And especially in marriages, when everybody running their mouth and everybody and the level is up to 100, somebody got to back it back down. Ooh. Then when the time presents itself, because you went in prayer, and God said, now is the time. For you to talk it out. Now it's calm. Now you can get the point across. Nobody gonna get a point across with everybody screaming and hollering. Nobody's gonna hear anything. Read for them. I'm about through. I gotta let you go.
To,
To the weak I became weak to win the weak. I have become all things to all people so that by all possible means I might save some. I do all this for the sake of the gospel that I may share in its blessing. Keep going. Do you not know that in a race, all the runners run?
In a race, everybody's running, but only one winner. Read.
But only one gets the prize. Run in such a way as to get the prize. Everyone who competes in the game goes into strict training.
You go into strict training. All athletes, before that season comes, they go into a strict training. They go into a strict self-discipline mode. When you run in this race, you got to stay in that training, self-discipline mode all the time. Paul said, I'm running like I'm in a race, but I'm running to win. Mm-hmm. Read.
They do it to get a crown that will not last, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. Therefore, I do not run like someone running aimlessly.
So I don't run like somebody just running just to be running. I got a purpose for my running. Read.
I do not fight like a boxer beating the air.
I don't fight like a boxer. Can you imagine a boxer just beating the air and somebody beating up on his head? But he's just beating the air. I don't fight like that. I'm fighting because I want to hit targets. I'm fighting because I'm fighting to win. I'm fighting because I'm fighting that whatever is the outcome, it's going to be eternal life for me. Read.
No, I strike a blow to my body.
I strike a blow. Read.
And make it my slave so that.
Make my body my slave. I bring my body under. I bring my body under control. Mm-hmm. See, some of y'all are going to sleep on this, but you're going to need
it.
This.
That's it.
I bring my body under control. I make it my slave. Read.
So that after I have preached to others. I myself.
Hold on just a minute. Because sometimes. We preachers, I'm saying we think we don't have to do anything. But the word come to me before it go to you. I have to bring my body subject. How can I tell you to do something I won't do? If I'm going to, God allow me to preach the gospel and you will get saved. But I'll lose my soul if I don't do what I've told you to do. So I bring my body subject that when I myself have preached to others, when I myself have witnessed to others, that I myself would not be a castaway. I would not be disqualified. See, God will use you because gifts and callings come without repentance. God will use your gifting, but you will miss Jesus. You will miss eternal life because you didn't bring yourself subject. You was doing anything, everything you're big enough to do in the church. I know God understand. He understand you don't want to live right. He understand he keep trying to work with you, but you just don't want to change. He understands that I've sent people and I've sent the word and I've sinned and I've sinned and I've sinned, but you won't hear because in your mind, you're going to do it the way you want to do it. And because you made up your mind to do it the way you want to do it, you have not brought yourself subject. I don't see the fruit of self-control in your life. I don't see the fruit that will keep you away from sin and evil. I see a person out of control, full of envy and jealousness, full of things that does not represent Christ. So as I'm closing, I know I've been closing for a minute now, but as I close, I want you to understand. Look at your life. What fruit is showing forth in your life? If the love is not there, if the peace is not there, if the gentleness or the forbearance, the long suffering, if the temperance is not there, if the kindness is not there, you need to go and reevaluate. And you need to surrender more to the Holy Spirit so that the Holy Spirit can direct your life. Sometimes we're trying to direct our own life because, you know, I'm grown. I can direct my life. Keep directing it. Keep being grown. But I want to please Jesus. I want him to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You fought a good fight. Come on, enter into the presence of the Lord. I want to hear those words. I want to see those streets of gold. I've seen enough potholes in the street. I paid Georgia Power too much money. I want to see the city that's lit up with the glory of God. I want to see those trees that's blooming for the healing of the nations. I want to be able to eat off one of those trees. I want to see those gates of pearl. Can you imagine one pearl on one gate? And they on all four gates. I want to see those things, Sister Nikki. So I bring myself subject now. I don't have to do what my flesh telling me to do now. I can let flesh go. I can let what people do to me go. Because I want Jesus. I want the best that he has. And if I want the best, then I got to give him my best. I discipline myself. I bring myself to church on time. I got to discipline myself. I be on the prayer line on time. I discipline myself. I do what I need to do. It's amazing. I keep saying I'm getting ready to give it up. How can you discipline yourself to go to work and get there on time, but when it comes to the things of God, you can't ever get there on time? Isn't that amazing? That means you care more for the things of the world than you do for God. Wow. I can get there. I'm going to get there 15 minutes early. Because I want that paycheck. But what about the eternal paycheck? What about that eternal when you stand before God and your record come up and he said, oh, you wasn't here on time. You were supposed to have been there at that such time and I was there and you wasn't there. Wow. How would you feel standing before God and him saying that to you? It's time. To let God have his way. Not my will, God, but let thine be done. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet. On this Mother's Day. Just lift your hands in his presence. And just begin to tell God, thank you. Say thank you, Jesus. Open your mouths and just say thank you, Jesus. Come on, open your mouths. Come on, let him hear your voice. Being grateful to Jesus. Let him hear your voice.
Spirit of,
come on, let him hear you.
Living God.
Think about how good he's been to you.
Father,
Think about how this year God brought you through so many things. When the devil thought he had you, God brought you out.
Spirit of the living.
He brought your children out. He brought your grandchildren out. Just think about how good God has been to you.
Spirit of,
thank you, Jesus.
The living God.
Thank you, God. See, self-discipline says, I was told to tell Jesus, thank you. But see how the enemy has kept many of your mouth closed? Because you can't, some of you can't get to the point of letting God know you appreciate him. Out of all the things you worked out of, the witchcraft, the sorcery, the divination, the thing you did to people, God is still merciful. He's still giving you a chance. Because the Bible says his mercies are renewed each and every day. His grace is abiding. Hallelujah. Just tell him thank you one more time.
Spirit of the living God,
Jesus,
fall fresh.
Thank you, God.
On me.
Thank you, Father.
Spirit of,
thank you, God.
The living God,
thank you, God.
Fall fresh on me.
Glory to God.
Have thine own way, Lord. Have thine own way.
Thank you, God.
You are the potter.
Yes, God.
And we are your clay.
Yes, God.
Mold and make us after your will.
Jesus.
Yielded and still.
Thank you, Jesus.
Spirit of the living God.
Thank you, God.
Fall fresh on me.
Thank you, God. Those of you that need housing, I know it's two or three of you in here. I just need you to lift your hands up. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, you see the hands that are uplifted today. Father, you said, oh God, where two or three come together, touching and agreeing on anything, that you would do it for us. Father, you said if we pray, believe. You said to ask and it shall be given. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, you are God that move in the midst of impossibilities. You are able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything that we can ever ask or think. So now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to move on their behalf. Father, you know the houses they need. You know the space they need. Father God, you know, God, their situation. You know their financial situation. You know everything, God. Now, Father, I pray right now that you would open the door. Lord, let it be quick, let it be fast, that they would testify that it was nobody but you. Lord God, I praise you for it now. I ask you to move. I ask you, God, to open that door for him, God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, and I thank you for it. In Jesus' name. Now I need the whole church just to lift up your hands and thank God for those houses. Thank God. Come on, let's come in agreement. Let's come in agreement. Come in agreement. Come in agreement. Let's come in agreement. Come in agreement. God, they need you to move. Some of them are working on time restraints. They need you to move, God. Hallelujah. Some of them are displaced, God. They need you to move. Open doors, God. Come on, come on, come on. Praise him for it. Praise him with them. Praise them for it. Praise God for it. God, I'm standing on your word. You told me to ask, and I'm asking for them. I'm asking for them, God. Glory, 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 glory. We worship you, God. 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 Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I gotta go. I gotta go. But I need those of you that really want a place coming. I just need you to touch my hand. Touch my hand. Nothing in my hand. Hallelujah. I'm just releasing. I'm just releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing a miracle. 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 Yeah, even in the finances. I'm releasing a miracle. 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 I'm breaking mindsets. I'm breaking mindsets. I'm breaking that mindset. I'm breaking it. I'm breaking it. I'm breaking it. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. I'm releasing. Now, now, now. Worry big hey. Taba. So torobo. Shake. I'm releasing now the miracle. 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 I'm a miracle. The miracle. The miracle. A miracle. A miracle. The miracle. The miracle. The miracle. The miracle. The miracle. I'm releasing it now. Wait a minute. All y'all needed a house. I'm releasing now. I'm releasing a miracle. A miracle. A miracle. A miracle. I'm releasing a miracle now. 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 In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing it now. Now, 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 now. Woo. I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing a right now miracle. I'm releasing a right now miracle. I'm releasing a right now miracle. Rebebebe ke sata ora basata baroba. I'm releasing a right now miracle. A right now miracle. Now, 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 now. There it is. Now. I'm releasing a miracle now. I'm breaking the mindset. I'm breaking the mindset. I'm breaking the mindset. I'm releasing a miracle now. Now, now that that door open, that door open, that door open, that door open. Woo. I'm releasing a miracle now. I'm releasing it now for he and his wife. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing it now. A miracle, the impossible. I'm releasing it now. 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 I'm releasing it now in Jesus' name. I'm releasing a miracle. I'm releasing a miracle now. I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing a miracle now. I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing it now. Now, 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 now. Father God, I'm releasing this miracle now in the name of Jesus. The mindset, I'm breaking, oh God, that mindset, and I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing a miracle now, 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 now. Rebeke baki daba sokura seke baka talalobo so rebe isarabaroba. I'm releasing it now, 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 in Jesus' name. Urebeke shatabaroba. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I'm releasing it now. I'm releasing it now. In the name of Jesus, move for it now. Make the difference now, God. In the name of Jesus, you see a heart. You see what she desired to do. I'm releasing that now. Now, 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 now. Urabase daba kurabasata baroba. Arabase baka tata bake bake daddy asada baroba eka tata 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 lobo so ora seketaba sata baroba. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Were you in line? Were you in line? He cut out of the, who else was in line? Come on. Thank you, God. Catch Sister Josie. Josie, catch your mom's hand. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. I thank you for I released a miracle right now, right now, right now. Right now, God, I thank you for a right now miracle. I thank you for opening that door. I thank you for that phone call that's going to come, that's going to open that door for it, God, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for I release that now. I release it now, 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 even in her body, even in her body. I release healing. 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 Purabasa, ready, sataba. Etabasa, ribebe ke daba, sokoribe ke, saketa la 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 bosu. I release it now in Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. I release the miracle now, now, in the name of Jesus. Ikoroboso, ribeke, satabarobo. Thank you, Lord. Horaba Shatada Dodoboshi. Isatada Dodoboso. Rebeke Shatabaroba. Oh, Father God, Idoroboso. Rebe Isatabarobo. Satada Dodobosi. Isate Beka Satabaroba. Otobaroba Satabaroba. I release, oh God, this miracle now in his body for healing now. I release it in his eyes. I release it in his body for healing now. For healing now. In the name of Jesus, I release a miracle. Yes. Yes. Yes, God. I release it now. In Jesus' name. I hear God say, it's time to stop running. He's been dealing with you, but it's time to stop running. Otabasi, Rabba, Shede, Basa, Rebecca, Baki, Bakatata, Basata. Pressure, I command you to go down now. Ida, Shede, Sokuriabasa, Rebe, Shatabaroba, Pressure, Ikataba, Italabasu, Etabaraba, Satabaroba. Yeah, yes, I release that miracle. I release a miracle now. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. I release it now. Come on, somebody give God praise.
You are great. You do miracles.
Father God, I release that now, that miracle. Father God, in the name of Jesus, on the weight of her giving, for she's a giver, God, on the weight of her giving. Lord God, I, oh God, ask you to let it come up as a memorial before you. And I ask you to move on her behalf. I ask you, God, yes, to perform a miracle. To perform a miracle in her home with her housing situation. Perform a miracle, God. Not only in a housing situation, but in a spiritual house. Perform a miracle. Perform a miracle. Perform a miracle. Perform a miracle. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Ooh. Ooh, Rebe, Baba, Sake, Daba, Sarabosso, Ro, Bochete, Ba, Raba, Socadididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididididid makia talalalaboso. Ekata maka basaita sataba sida bokura. Sotorabasa ye makatalalabasa. In Jesus' name. Somebody give God glory. Come on, somebody praise him. Come on, somebody praise him. Come on, somebody exhort the Lord. Exhort him, exhort him, exhort him. Exhort the Lord. Just how you praise God then. Hallelujah. That's how you praise God then. You got saved praising God. You a praiser. God wanted you to continue to praise him. As you praise him, you're going to see miracles. As you praise him, you're going to see things turn, things change. And it's going to change for your good. But you got to praise him for it. Before you see it, you got to praise him. You understand? All right. Jesus. Somebody ought to give God praise. Somebody ought to praise him. Somebody ought to exhort the Lord. Somebody ought to exhort him. Exhort him. Exhort him. Exhort him. Exhort him. Exhort him. Exhort the Lord. Exhort him. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Ooh. Yes. 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 Right there. Right there. There. Healing, 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 healing. Watch him. Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Bring Mr. Sam over here for me, please. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Come on, come down, Pastor. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Get me some oil. Thank you, God. Come on, somebody give God praise. Yeah. Praise him before you see it. 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 Before you see it. Before you see it. Before you see it. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Rebeke shata da 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 Arabasi korebe shatabaroba. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, Urabasatabaroba, I release a miracle into his hand right now. In the name of Jesus, I release a miracle right now. All the tormenting spirits, God, the tormenting. Oh, God's forces, God. In Jesus' name. I release the miracle. I release the miracle. I release the miracle. I release the strength. I release the strength. I release the strength. I release the strength right now. In the name of Jesus. I come against every force. Every force. Everything, God, that come to drain it. I come against that. I break it
in the name of Jesus.
I break it. Oh, rabba, 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 all the pressure. I release it. I release it. I release it. I release it. Hey, yeah, yeah. Taba, say, tata, baroba. Shut up. Oh, shit. Yeah, all of that. All of it. All of it. All of it. All of it. Go. Go.
There is no one else.
of your head. It's gone. Is that pressure that was in your head, is it still gone? Is it still there? Now, Father, I release your anointing and I release your power. Father, it's not by power nor by might, but it's by your spirit, said the Lord. And I cancel every assignment of the enemy. Yeah, I break the generational curses. Generational doors, let them be closed forever. Let them be closed forever. Lord God, let them be broken back. 1,000 generations on his father's side. 1,000 generations on his mother's side. Let those... Jesus. Let those doors be closed in the name of Jesus. Yes, and I thank you. I thank you, God. I thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I heard the Holy Spirit say you gotta forgive. It's some things you still holding, and it comes up from time to time. But he said, let them go. Let them go. And those hurts go all the way back to your mom. He said, let them go. Release them right now. As if you throwing them off. He said, throw them off now. Begin to throw. Begin to throw.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes. Come on, don't be spectators. Come on. Come on, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. And just repeat after me. Say, Father God, those things that hurt so bad that it seemed like I couldn't let it go, by an act of my will, by an act of my will, I let it go today. I cut free from it today, that I go free. Father God, I thank you, Father God, for your freedom.
This day,
I go free. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
now
name.
Now somebody praise God with me.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Now every person that you saw that came up in your spirit, release them today. Release them. You don't even have a call about out loud. Just in your mind, release them. Everyone. Yes. Yes. Release them. Now, Father God, by an act of his will, he has chosen to let him go. Lord, you know it's hard, but you are God that deal in hard things. And from this day forward, he go free. He go free, God, in the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody give God praise. Come on, somebody give him praise. Somebody honor God, honor God, honor God, honor God. Honor the Lord, honor the Lord, honor the Lord.
Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. Thank God for an awesome word. Amen. Please go back and read
Even if you had to do a study on self-control, we gonna work it Tuesday. Amen. Awesome word. But I heard God say when she was praying for those that needed a place to stay. On today, you might have something to do or somewhere to go. You need to go get you a key, a blank key, as a sign of what God getting ready to do. It's very prophetic. You might not understand it. It might sound crazy.
Yes, God.
But get a key. Go buy a key. Don't have now made. Go buy a blank key. Go buy a blank key. Amen. Amen. We thank God for our awesome move on today. That he loves us so much that he will stop by and give you a word like this in this shifting season. Amen. Amen. Because he wants us to shift as a team. Not no island, but a team. Amen. If nothing else, we're going to ask our finance committee to please prepare ourselves. Amen. How many know a 10% of your earning belong to who? Amen. And if you want a mighty move of God on the weight of your offering, and sow a seed. Amen. If you need a tithe and offering envelope, please raise your hand. It's more a blessing to give than it is to. Amen. Amen. We thank God for a move of him on today. No walking, please. This is still worship. This is still worship. Tithe and offering envelope, please you raise your hand.
Offering time, blessing time, offering time. We want to be a blessing today in our giving. We want to give liberty unto the Lord. So we're going to ask that you prepare your hearts to give and remember to sow a seed. In your giving, God gives seeds to the soil, so we want to be a blessing. And as you prepare yourself, we want you to stand to your feet, and we're going to put you in the hands of the usher. God loves a what kind of giver? A cheerful giver.
Thank you.
I'm a free worshiper. Y'all help me.
I'm a free worshiper. I'm a free worshiper. Lord, I'm free. I'm a free worshiper. I'm a free worshiper.
You will help us out. Can you all help us out with $50? You that we praise God for our giving at this time. We're going to ask you to, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you, oh God, for our giving, God. Lord, for you told us to bring in our tithes and our offering into the storehouse, oh God. Lord, we ask you, God, to replenish your people, oh God, Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you, oh God, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for the overflow, oh God. We thank you, God, that you will meet every need, oh God, Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you, God, that you will rebuke the hand of the enemy, God, off of our finances, oh God. And Father God, in the name of Jesus, we ask you to curse every spirit of mama off our finances, oh God. And we thank you, God, as we lift this up, God, for the upbuilding of your kingdom, oh God. And we thank you, oh God, on your behalf, oh God. And we give you glory, praise, and honor. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Ask you to receive our announcer at this time.
Amen. Amen. We bless.
you guys coming out on this Mother's Day. Amen. Amen. And we want to say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers as well. We want to bless God for none other than our leaders. Amen. All of which who are mothers. Amen. Can we give them a hand clap of praise? None other than our apostle, our overseer, Apostle Brenna D. Howard. Our pastor, Pastor Ann Hall. Co-pastor Cedric and First Lady Thais. We bless God for Elder D'Amica Pinckney. We bless God for Apostle Kim Jenkins. We bless God for everyone in their respectful places. Just a few announcements today. There will be no services in Forsyth, but we will see you next Sunday. Happy Mother's Day from TAP Forsyth. Also, on this coming Tuesday at 6 p.m., we will have a church meeting before service, so we're asking that everyone please make sure that you are here on time promptly at 6 p.m. That's this Tuesday before Bible study. Starting next Saturday, every person that does something in the ministry will need to be on the prayer line for the month of May from 9 p.m. till 10 p.m. to pray for Sunday service. If you cannot be on the prayer line, please let Pastor Ann know. However, please do not call when it is close to prayer time unless it is an emergency. This is no excuses because this is very important. And this is strictly from our pastor, Pastor Ann Hall. Amen. 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 Also, please be reminded that this coming Thursday, which will be May the 12th, we will be traveling to Apostle Holt's church for his birthday celebration, which will be Thursday night at 7 p.m. at the Macon location. And on May the 14th, which will be Saturday, Pastor Queen will have her annual meeting, and it will be on Zoom, and we will have that link out to you as soon as possible. And these are all the announcements that I have for you. Please govern yourselves accordingly as I turn into the hands of Deacon Harold Lewis. Okay.
I want to thank God for everything that God has done today. Amen. God is good. We have a couple of seed offerings we want to receive now. Amen. But before we do that, amen, how many graduates we have in here this year? How many is graduating? Amen. I know next year we have some. So, Sister Nikki, we just want to bless you. Amen. We honor you. Amen. Glory to God for, amen, your achievements. Amen. And everybody, I think next year we have two or three that's coming out. And one thing I've always done, I've always gone to graduations. Amen. And to show you that I'm concerned about you, that I'm pushing you. Amen. And I want you to go farther than just graduation. Amen. I want you to either go to college or go to somewhere to get some further education so that you can get you a decent job. Amen. Amen. I'm pushed that and I'll continue to push it. Amen. Thank God for Dominique being home. Amen. Glory to God. And I hear she's getting ready to be shipped out. Amen. But we thank God. Let's continue to keep her in prayer. Amen. We thank God again for all our mothers. Now, those of you that have seed offerings, we're going to ask you to come right now. Amen. We're going to get out of the way for the men. They are excited. Amen. Now, we got to be just as excited on Father's Day. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you right now, God, for that she's sowing for today. We ask you to bless it. Lord God, everything, oh God, that she desired to do, everything that you desire for her to do from this point forward, Father, we thank you for the prophetic intercessor.
We thank you, Lord God, for even the, oh God, the, oh God, the doors that you open, oh God, in her profession, Lord God. I don't see you staying at Bruce. I see God opening another door for you. But it seems like it's more on a state level than a city level. Father, we bless you for that now. And we thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. And as we, oh God, sow the seed, God, it goes in the ground and die and bring forth the harvest for which it's planted for. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Thank you, God. Father, we thank you that as she, Lord God, sows this first fruit unto you, Father, we thank you for the job. We thank you, Lord God, that it will not just be temporary, it will be permanent. Father, we thank you for her strength. Lord, we thank you right now, God, in the name of Jesus, for even increases on that job. Father, we thank you for favor and influence. We bless you for that now, God, in the name of Jesus. And Father God, even let her finances begin to stretch, Lord God, that, oh God, everything will be brought up, oh God, Father God, to where it needs to be. Father, we thank you right now, God, in the name of Jesus, that as she sowed a seed, Lord God, Father, we plant it, oh God, in the ground, Lord God, and it will come forth and bring forth the harvest for which it's sown for. Father, we thank you for these first fruits. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. 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 We thank God for everything that's been done. Deacon Harold, you can come on now.
Let's try it again. Let the church say amen. I'm excited. Today is Mother's Day. And I sure miss my mom. But men, can y'all bring the table out? He needs some help, guys. Oh, Jimmy, right now. All the men, don't be scared. Even you ain't gave anything, still come out and support the men, mothers today. We should be proud of our moms, our mothers. You know, it's fitting that the apostle preached about your first fruit, and I have been writing over there, and when I was writing, I was saying love, joy, and peace. We the men love you, mothers, wives, sisters, and friends with love. And on the back, I said, love, never give up. Just because you don't have a mama, don't stop loving. Because love, never give up. I stole that from her. The reason why we put the sheet over the table because we know the apostle and Pastor Ann are gonna look when they walk back there. That's why we did it. So you take the sheets off. All right, now we got more stuff than usual. How about that? Okay, I'm gonna let you start it off. Everybody see Mr. Merrick. He's real nervous, but he needs to start doing this. So receive Mr. Merrick. Stop being nervous. You ain't nervous. You know these people in this church. Stop being nervous. Okay. Well, you know, I'm kind of loud, so I need to be loud. I don't know what the box is for, so we need to go ahead and give the box. Okay, Mr. Murray.
And you have another gift.
The box kind of heavy, ain't it? He's struggling, too. Amen. Amen. Okay. Okay. Now, we want to do this first before we give anything else to our apostle and our pastor, because you know we start from the head down. So we want the youngest mom to come up. The youngest mom to come up. Now, everybody ain't got to get up at one time. You know who the youngest mom is. Third of one. Kiki, how old are you? 66. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hear. I'm sorry. We have a gift card for the youngest mom. You know that smile. She got such a beautiful smile. Okay. And we're going to go with the oldest mom, passing the mic.
The oldest mom.
The oldest mom.
Who is the oldest mom?
Mother Franklin.
We want to ask the oldest mom to please
come up. Yeah, the oldest mom, please come up. Tell him, baby, tell him.
I think that's Miss Jerry. Miss. Yeah. Mother Franklin.
Mother Franklin.
Mother Franklin, I'll take it to you.
All right.
She's 80. So she's the oldest mom. You know that. You know what? That was nice. That was nice. Courtney was saying, like, do I have to do this? The oldest mom, I set him up on that one. Okay, now, we're going to pass the mic, because I want this year the men's to get involved in doing more things, not just me. You know, because everybody know that I'm the pastor's son, apostle brother. I am the apostle brother, so I want to get, she always treated me like a mom, I treat her like a mom, but I am the brother, so I want to get the men's more involved in doing things, because this is our year, guys. This is our year. That if you see, when I first got up here and started doing here, we had maybe one or two guys, and now it's growing, and that's what we want in ministry. We want it to grow. So, we want to pass the mic and let Dante be the next speaker. Dante, whatever. D, how about D, okay? Let him talk.
The next gift we have is for Apostle.
How y'all do? I want to wish every mother a happy Mother's Day. I want to always get this pill to Pastor Ann. I know. manager, Banana Dupree.
Okay, happy Mother's Day, everybody. But everybody who is a mother, please come up and get your gift. Okay. You get one of each gift.
Let me make a correction before we move forward. The Zaire's bags came from the whole church. It didn't come from the men's. It came from the whole church. Okay? I just want to make a correction on that. Since I'm the last, these two gifts here, they also is for our leader, my nephew is home and his wife. So the church, the men's, got Pastor Cedric a gift. And we got his wife, Tahir, a gift. We just want to bless the leaders, okay? So did everybody get something? I mean, moms, okay? Now we want to open it up because we hear that other people have gift for the apostle or Pastor Ann or whoever they want to give to. I'm not a mom. So we open the flow up. Oh, we want to give Pastor Ann and Apostle one. And we didn't give, yes, we didn't give Mama one. Oh, I didn't want to tell, I wanted to tell what these things was. I didn't even tell y'all, did I? They know what they did. They know what they did, Miss Murray. Yes, you have to open it. Okay, it's a madness to my game. The reason you got the cosmetic pack, cosmetic thing to look at yourself, because we have some beautiful ladies in this church. I thought it was not fitting that you can carry a mirror around with you, so you don't always have to stand in the mirror. So that's why I gave everybody a mirror. So did everybody get one? Well, I don't have, if you're not a mom, you didn't get one? Charlotte one and Gabby. You got one? Your mama got one. Who didn't get anything? Didn't get anything. And some more. Oh, William. I don't know if should I give William, not my brother-in-law. I don't know if should I do that. I don't know. He gave us a donation. He did. Oh, okay. You gonna give it to him? Okay, you go give it to him. As my brother-in-law, I could talk to him like that. Okay, so we just want to thank everybody for what y'all have been doing, but we want to say a prayer before we leave. And I want to pick a guy to say a prayer for. And I don't want the guys to be nervous. Mr. Murray, don't run. Because this season, the men's going to have to start praying. So I'm going to ask D to say a prayer for the ladies and for the mothers of this church. Yeah, that's all right with y'all. Okay, Mr. Murray went and got more candy for anybody that wanted candy. So we're going to ask D to pray. Thank you very much. That's what we have. So do anybody else have gift for the apostle and Pastor Ann? Y'all can come up now.
Say happy Mother's Day to Apostle Howard and Pastor Ann. Thank you for being here for me. Thank you.
You're in the right place. God bless. I just wanted to say I want to say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers here in the house and to each and every one of y'all. I appreciate the sisterhood that I have gotten the opportunity to bond with you all, and I am very grateful to be here to celebrate Mother's Day with you. And Apostle, I love you very dearly. Pastor Ann, I love you also. I've given you guys my Mother's Day card, and I have Mother's Day card for the other ladies. I won't proclaim the time. I give it to you after service.
Amen. Anybody else? I need to turn it back over to the apostle. Receive her as she comes.
Amen. We thank God for our men. Come on, give them a hand. Amen. They take it to the next level this time. And I appreciate God for our men. I thank God for everything that you have done. I thank God for how y'all have poured into us. Amen. And I pray, amen, for every gift, every card, everything. Amen. That God will bless you tremendously. Amen. Amen. I'm just grateful, amen, for God. And you seeing us as leaders that you can, amen, that you don't mind pouring into. That's a blessing to me. Amen. Amen. We just thank God for everything.
Amen. Anything else, Pastor Ann? Amen. We bless God for all the mothers today. We pray that you all have a blessed day. Amen. We pray that, amen, that all is well, amen, when you get home. If nothing else, amen. We wanna stand. Let us pray. Jace, you didn't come give him a hug, baby. I'm going to have to get my hug from you. Oh, you're getting tall.
Bless you.
Hey, amen. He getting tall. Hallelujah. We thank God for him. Amen. When you see that baby, you see a miracle, amen. What God can do, amen. Every mind clear, everybody happy, amen. Let us pray. The Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for everything that's been done today. We thank you for our men, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for every, oh God, Father God, person that have graced this building today. We ask you to bless them, to strengthen them, Lord God. Father, we ask you, oh God, hallelujah, Lord God, that, oh God, when they leave this place, oh God, that they will never, ever, ever leave your presence. We ask you to bless them, and so, God, Father God, only you can do. Give us traveling mercies, Lord God, as we go from this place today. Help us, oh God, to, oh God, love on one another, Lord God, and let one another know, Lord God, that we, oh God, are part of the body of Christ. Father, we praise you and we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.